الختام والصلاة والسلام. آتي محمد الوسيلة الفضيلة وبعث مقام المحمود الذي وعدته. الحمد لله، الحمد لله الواحد الأحد الفرد الصمد الذي لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وخليله، أرسله بالحق بشيرًا ونذيرًا وداعيًا إلى الله بإذنه وسراجًا منيرًا. اللهم صلِّ وسلِّم وبارِك عليه وعلى آله، وارض اللهم عن أصحابه، واجعلنا اللهم منهم وممن سار على نهجه واستنى بسنته واهتدى بهداه إلى يوم الدين. يقول ربنا سبحانه وتعالى: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله، اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، إخوتي في الله، I would like to begin with an example where one of the most affluential people in the world, the richest of people, whether it's in monetary value, whatever it is, decides to employ a group of people, dedicated group of people, in order for him or her, let's say him for now, we're not being against the sisters, in order for him to entrust them with his wealth and his assets, in order for them to run this abundance for him. And obviously this process involves real very difficult criteria. They go through this difficult criteria, tamhis, filtering. And this person says, listen folks, I'm gonna give you the staff manual, so to speak. When you get employed somewhere, they tell you this is what you should do, this is what you shouldn't do. Oh, I'm going to give you, there's nothing that is going to be ambiguous. If there is an ambiguity, something not clear, come to me, I'll explain to you. Right? So, أغنى الأغنياء أعلن وظيفة عنده ليختار أناسا ليقربهم إليه ويستأمنهم على ثروته. أعطاهم دليلا ليتبعوه وقال إن اتبعتم الدليل. These are my thoughts in Arabic. تقدمتم. So if you follow this staff manual or this manual or this guide, you are going to move forward in your employment with me. وتترقوا في العط إن أنتم أخلصتم وأعطيتم من وقتكم ترقيتم في عطاءاتكم. And similarly, if you are sincere in your employment to me, you work only for me, and you dedicate more time, your عطاء, your gifts are going to be more. However, he says to them, I'm still with this example, أريدكم أن تتصلوا بي خمس مرات في اليوم. I would like you to establish a connection, not just call me, establish a connection. Later on I'm going to talk about the word establish a connection. في أوقات محددة حسب ما أطلب منكم. In specific times, I decide that I'm the one who's giving, not you. You don't call the shots, I call the shots. Now, so, وَلِحِرْصِ عَلَيْكُمْ أُنَادِيكُمْ لِأُذَكِّرَكُمْ. And in order for you not to lose out, not to miss out, I will call you for these five times. I will tell you when they are, I will call you to these times. So the more كُلَّمَا أَخْلَصْتُمْ, as I said, كُلَّمَا زِدْتُكُمْ. Right? And if you're not sincere in your work, we all have mishaps. We're not machines. Even machines have errors at times. So he's saying, if you make mistakes, if you slack off, not the same dedication, I will send messages here and there. Maybe a reminder, maybe you lose something, whatever it is. But eventually, if you don't respond to my many reminders, I will have no option but to terminate this contract. This is just an example. And when we respond to this call, there is something, there is a drive. قوة إيمان تدفعنا إلى العمل الدؤوب لأننا نستحضر الثواب. Because at that time, when we are thinking of all the, it is a bit complicated. It's not easy. It's not like, I'm going to give you this million or whatever you ask because I've got it all, he's saying. It's an open check. But you don't sit and get it. There are really obligations there. But regardless of the obligations, you are really enthusiastic. If you are, a person who cares, some people, subhanAllah, it doesn't matter to them. So if you have the drive, it doesn't matter how hard you work because you are thinking of the thawab, of the fruit or of the compensation that you are going to get. Now, walillahi al-mathlul a'la, Allah is above all examples, of course. Now, when we talk about the richest or this influential or the most influential of people, when we talk about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, His Malikul Muluk, the King of Kings, Rabbul Alameen, the Lord of everything that exists, the one who gives, مَا لَا عَيْنٌ رَأَتْ وَلَا أُذُنٌ سَمِعَتْ وَلَا خَطَرَ عَلَى قَلْبِ بَشَرٍ. He can give that which no eyes have ever seen, no ears have ever heard of, and no heart or mind has ever imagined. Just like, forgive me for saying this, this person who's got so much wealth can really deliver the unimaginable for people. I mean, think of someone who had nothing in his life or her life, and now you open it. So no one can give more than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He sent the Quran to us, did not leave us like this. And I say to brothers and sisters who have doubts about the Creator, have you ever heard of any human being or any being that claimed the creation of the heavens and the earth or the creation of man? No one. And have you ever seen anything that can make itself by itself? We don't believe in this. I mean, this is a whole topic on its own. So He sent to us the Quran. وَأَخْبَرَنَا عَنْ عَدُوِّنَا إِبْلِيسَ. And He told us, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, your main hurdle, you are going to have hurdles, and one of the main hurdles is Iblis. Is طاووس الملائكة, Ibn Kathir mentions at the time, the pride of the angels. That's how much knowledge he had. Subhanallah. But knowledge with no purification is a path of destruction. Right? Told us Iblis, you have an enemy that is Iblis. وَأَخْبَرَنَا عَنْ عَدُوِّنَا إِبْلِيسِ وَكَيْفَ أَغْوَى أَبَانَا وَأُمَّنَا. And He told us, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in the Quran, how Iblis succeeded in misleading our mother and our father, Adam and Hawa. In Islam, we don't have the original sin. When Allah addresses Adam and Hawa, both of them, أَلَمْ أَنْهَكُمَا عَنْ تِلْكُمَا الشَّجَرَةِ. Allah says, haven't I forbade you, both of you? وَأَقُلْ لَكُمَا, haven't I said to you? Subhanallah. So men and women are equal before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah showed us how Iblis misled us, how he misled Adam alayhi salam. In Surah Al-A'raf, I don't want to get sidetracked, but just to give an example. قَالَ مَا نَهَاكُمَا رَبُّكُمَا عَنْ تِلْكُمَا الشَّجَرَةِ. Look, subhanallah, and this is also, at times, Shaitan or Iblis comes to us with the most convincing of arguments. Yani, one of the most disturbing things I've heard recently, wallahi, and it's going to upset some brothers. In general, in Australia, we have the problem of domestic violence, where a lady dies every week, at least. The worst of things is when Shaitan comes to a Muslim man and says to him, you can abuse your wife. That's in the Quran. And then you end up inflicting such harm on the mother of your kids, who is her body is going to change forever, carrying your children. Yet you do this to her. If she was your sister or your daughter, wallahi, somebody told me, they were put in a test. You know, spouses will always have problems. SubhanAllah, one of the sheikhs said, when he gave an advice, I don't think we'll get through our, that's not new to me, inshallah, see how we go. He gave an advice to a newly married couple. He said to the man, he said, tell me, son, were there times where you did something and then after something you say, oh, I shouldn't have done that.
لا أقسم بيوم القيامة ولا أقسم بالنفس اللوامة. Reproaching نفس.
Why did you do that?
And the guy said, yes, absolutely, Sheikh.
He said, remember, you have fights with your own self. And you reconcile, say, okay, I'm not going to do this again. This is, it was stupid, absolutely stupid. Right?
So he said to me, this brother, he said, I really, my wife gave it to you. She was really, really confronting. And by the way, brothers, when we are patient with our wives, that's not a weakness. That is a strength.
I don't want to get sidetracked, but the Prophet ﷺ, his wives used to yuraji'nahu. They would ask, they would chat back. And Sayyidina Umar once got really, he told Hafsa, Sayyidina Hafsa, aturaji'una, aturaji'ina Rasul, do you really?
And once he actually left them for a month, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I'm trying to, so this brother said to me, when my wife gave me a hard time, and I really tried to be kind to her. And then I said to myself, I said, okay, if she was my sister, or if she was my daughter, how would I have liked her husband to treat her? And he said, and he's a person who prays salah, mashallah, I'm getting to salah. But not the salah that is just salah on the outside, where there's no benefit. It's like people, it's like someone on a treadmill, mashallah, you know, on the, let's say this, I saw this, this funny thing where he had the chair on, right, on the sides. And the treadmill was good. That's not exercising. It looks like exercising, but it's not exercising. So this brother is someone, as far as I know, Allah Uzakiha, Allah prays Salah properly. Allah comes first in his life. So he said to himself, إِذَا كَانَتْ أُخْتِي أَوْ إِبْنَتِي فَإِنَّنِي سَأَتَمَنَّى مِنْ زَوْجِهَا أَنْ يَذْهَبَ إِلَيْهَا وَيَصْطَلِحَ مَعَهَا وَيَجْبُرَ خَاطِرَهَا. He said, I would have loved him to go. She's my sister. She's my daughter. And he said, Alhamdulillah, it was so easy for me to fight my ego. وَنَهَا النَّفْسَ عَنِ الْهَوَىٰ, Allah says. He fought his ego and he went to his wife. And kindness breeds kindness. هَلْ جَزَاءُ الْإِحْسَانِ إِلَّا الْإِحْسَانِ. They are vulnerable. Show love and kindness, inshallah, it will be reciprocated. And he said, this was it. Subhanallah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us, you know, when Iblis comes and gives us these ideas to abuse our spouses, for example, or abuse our children, it's no longer about halal and haram. This is a case of abuse. This is a case of a criminal that needs to be dealt with. Subhanallah. How did he mislead them? قَالَ مَا نَهَاكُمَا رَبُّكُمَا عَنْ تِلْكُمَ الشَّجَرَةِ. Your Lord did not forbid you from this tree. إِلَّا أَن تَكُونَ مَلَكَيْنَ. Except that you become angels. أَوْ تَكُونَ مِنَ الْخَالِدِينَ. Or you become eternal. On top of that, Allahu Akbar, Iblis. They've never had, this bear in mind, they've never had an encounter with Iblis before. وَقَاسَمَهُمَا. On top of that. He said, أُقْسِمُ بِاللَّهِ. He took an oath by Allah. He has no deen, no religion. Allahu Akbar. I swear by Allah, I am but a sincere advisor to you. Subhanallah. In Surah Taha, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, a different angle related to salah, inshallah. I'm getting there eventually. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I'm not going to go into the details, but eventually when they eat from the tree, and the tree, we don't need to know what tree it is, all we need to know the simulator. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says do's and don'ts. Don't focus on the don'ts. There are so many do's. And I get annoyed sometimes. Why doesn't Allah allow us to eat pig? Oh, pig has certain... Ya akhi, just save yourself from this. Quran is not about science. It's not, we don't say, science say this, the Quran says... No, no. Allah says don't eat pork. Khalas, alhamdulillah. He gives me hundreds of things to eat. So we need to remember this. فَأَكَلَا مِنْهُمَا. When they ate from that tree, they've been tricked. فَبَدَتْ لَهُمَا سَوْآتُهُمَا. The private parts that's supposed to be covered, now revealed. وطفقا يخصفان عليهما من ورق الجنة. And they started to cover themselves from the leaves of the Jannah. And then Adam عليه السلام وعصى آدم شكرا وعصى آدم ربه فغوى. And Adam, Allahu Akbar, disobeyed his Lord, so and strayed into error. البعد عن منهج الله عذاب. Before I go on, my dear brothers and sisters, lots of points. When we talk about prophets and messengers, they may make mistakes, but they don't sin. This is very important. Adam alayhi salam, did they eat from the tree on purpose? La. وَلَقَدْ عَهِدْنَا إِلَىٰ آدَمَ مِنْ قَبْلُ فَنَسِي وَلَمْ نَجِدْ لَهُ عَزْمًا. He forgot. All of us forget. So, for example, I'll give a very, very quick example. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the Battle of Badr, when they captured these 70 of the Meccans, who came to annihilate them, أَتَوْ لِيَقْتُلُوا الْمُسْلِمِينَ وَأَذِنَ اللَّهُ لِنَبِيِّهِ بِقِتَالِهِمْ أُذِنَ لِلَّذِينَ يُقَاتَلُونَ لآخر الآية. نعم. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم had a shura. What do we do with this? 70 of them. Now, I want you to remember something. The overwhelming attribute of Rasulullah SAW, he is rahmatun lil alamin. He's a mercy into everything that Allah created. Abu Bakr gives an opinion, radiyallahu anhu. And he says, Ya Rasulullah, they are our family. I'll say it quickly, nakhtasiruha. He said, Ya Rasulullah, let them pay the ransom. Let them teach the illiterate amongst us, etc. That's the opinion of Abu Bakr. Umar, radiyallahu anhu, al-Faruq. Ya Rasulullah, they've come. You can imagine what Sayyidina Umar would say, wouldn't you? You would, absolutely. They've come to annihilate us. They didn't come to give us gifts, Ya Rasulullah. Not only allow us to kill them. No. Give me, my family members, give each of us, they, relatives, we will take care of them. Now the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, amazingly, brilliantly, intelligently, he makes both of them feel valued and treasured, that their opinions are really weighty. So he says to Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, he says, your example is like that of Ibrahim alayhi salam. When he said, I mean, who would want to be compared to Ibrahim? Khalilullah, the beloved of Allah. When he said, وَإِذْ قَالَ إِبْرَاهِيمُ رَبِّ اجْعَلْ هَذَا الْبَلَدَ آمِنًا وَاجْنُبْنِي وَبَنِيَّ أَن نَّعْبُدَ الْأَصْنَامَ رَبِّ إِنَّهُنَّ أَضْلَلْنَ كَثِيرًا مِّنَ النَّاسِ. He says, my Lord, those idols misled many people. Because idol worship, لا يوجد مسؤولية, لا يوجد تكليف. You do whatever you want, present something to the idols, that's it, forgiven, right? Allah, Allah, Allah. فَمَنْ تَبِعَنِي, he says to Allah, whoever follows me, فَإِنَّهُ مِنِّي, he belongs to me. Now naturally you'd say, whoever doesn't belong to me, what's a natural thing to say? He's لَيْسَ مِنِّي. لَكِنَّهُ قَالْ وَمَنْ عَصَانِي, whoever disobeys me, فَإِنَّكَ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ, you are extremely forgiving, all merciful. And then he looked at Sayyidina Umar and he said to him, and your example is like that of Nuh alayhi salam. 950 years. وَمَا آمَنَ مَعْهُ إِلَّا قَلِيلٌ, about 80 people. It's like 10 per a century. Eventually, I mean, what do you imagine? قَالَ نُوحُ الرَّبِّ لَا تَذَرْ عَلَى الْأَرْضِ مِنَ الْكَافِرِينَ دَيَّارًا إِنَّكَ إِنْ تَذَرْهُمْ يُضِلُّ عِبَادَكَ وَلَا يَلِدُوا إِلَّا فَاجِرًا كَفَّارًا. He said, my Lord, don't leave any disbeliever on earth. إِنَّكَ إِنْ تَذَرْهُمْ, for if you leave them, to live, they're not going to even, not only are they not going to worship, but they're going to prevent others from worship. يُضِلُّ عِبَادَكَ وَلَا يَلِدُوا إِلَّا فَاجِرًا كَفَّارًا. And their offspring that are going to come, فاجر, corrupt, كَفَّارًا, extremely disbelieving. Which opinion did he take, صلى الله عليه وسلم? That of Abu Bakr. Which opinion was Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala happy with?
That of Umar radiallahu anhu, as mentioned in the Quran, in Surah Tawbah. Yet at the time, whatever the Prophet gives, we have وَمَا آتَاكُمُ الرَّسُولُ فَخُذُوهُ وَمَا نَهَاكُمْ عَنْهُ فَانْتَهُ. If we do not have examples in the Prophets and the Messengers, how can we relate to them? Okay, let's move on. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَمَنِ اتَّبَعُهُ قَالَ اهْبِطَ مِنْهَا جَمِيعًا. There's one in Surah Al-Baqarah, قُلْ مَهْبِطُوا مِنْهَا جَمِيعًا. We're going to focus on Surah Taha because it's related to Salah. Allah said, اهْبِطَ مِنْهَا, both of you, jinn and mankind, بَعْضُكُمْ لِبَعْضٍ عَدُوٍ, you are going to be enemies for each other. Listen to this carefully now. فَإِمَّا يَأْتِيَنَّكُمْ مِنِّي هُدَى. If guidance comes to you from me, فَمَنِ اتَّبَعَ هُدَايَ Allah, فَلَا يَضِلُّ وَلَا يَشْقَى. Whomsoever follows my guidance shall neither go astray nor shall suffer any misery. Subhanallah. And then the next one, وَمَنْ أَعْرَضَ عَنْ ذِكْرِي فَإِنَّ لَهُ مَعِيشَةً ضَنْكَى. On the opposite, whoever turns away from my remembrance, they will have a restrained, constrained life. ضَنْكَى. Now, what is the remembrance of Allah? وَمَنْ أَعْرَضَ عَنْ ذِكْرِي. I'm going to take you back to Surah Taha. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala communicates with Musa alayhi salam, إِنَّنِي أَنَا اللَّهِ. He says to him, I am Allah. لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا أَنَا. There is no God but me. No deity worthy of worship but me. فَعْبُدْنِي. Worship me. Immediately, وَأَقِمِ الصَّلَاةِ لِذِكْرِي. Establish prayer for my remembrance. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not say to him, صَلِّي لِذِكْرِي. قال أقم الصلاة. ما الفرق بين إقامة الصلاة والصلاة؟ أن تقيم الشيء أن يستقيم أن يكون مستقيما ومؤديا مهمته في حياتك. Establishing prayer is when we make sure that when it's time for prayer, I leave everything. The only thing that is established at the time is my salah. Hence, that takes me to the topic of our Jum'ah, because it's almost, the time is almost up, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose for us, for the way to call us to Him. Remember what the example I gave earlier. For this call to be done through a human voice. Abdullah ibn Zayd, Imam Bukhari and others mentioned this riwayah. This hadith, subhanallah, when an angel came and taught him the adhan, Abdullah ibn Zayd, and then he came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam aqarrahu, approved it, and immediately said, عَلِّمْهُ Bilal, فَإِنَّهُ أَنْدَى مِنْكَ صَوْتًا. He said, go teach it to Bilal, he has a more beautiful voice. Bilal didn't get angry, by the way. The brothers who give adhan, please, for Allah's sake, if you don't have a beautiful voice, either get training, or don't you give adhan straight. Because when the muadhin gives the adhan, it should, like, you know, so, an imam in Cape Town gave me this example. I said, you know, it's like you cast this, he loves fishing. So you cast, when you make the adhan, you cast this rod and you catch the hearts, bring them to the masjid. عَلِّمْهُ Bilal, teach it to Bilal. And then when Bilal gave the adhan, Umar radiallahu anhu heard, and he came, يَجُرُّ ثَوْبَهُ, dragging his, he said, Ya Rasulullah, I heard the same words in my dream. The words of adhan. My advice to you, my dear brothers, even if you're alone at home, try to make adhan, not the fancy adhan, just the words of adhan, because the words of adhan, I'll end soon inshallah, are the affirmations to the cause and purpose of our existence. If we can fulfill them, when we say Allahu Akbar, Allah is greater of what? Anything I'm doing now. Fajr is 3:15. Yes, no problem. I'll be there, inshaAllah. You will train me, ya Allah. Allahu Akbar. Allah is greater. Allah is greater. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. I testify. There is no God. There's no one deity worthy of worship but Allah. Ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. He is my guide. لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسُوٌ حَسَنٌ. حَيَّ عَلَى الصَّلَاةِ. Not تعالى إلى الصلاة تعالى حيا. Make an effort. If you can master your salah, hayya ala al-falah, that will lead you to absolute, comprehensive, holistic success. If we can get our salahs right, there's nothing else in life that we will not be able to get. I'll end with a little joke, a real one, where somebody came, ata liyakhtiba, he came to propose. So the girl said to the father, اسألهُ يا والدي عن وقت صلاة الفجر هذه الأيام. Ask him about the Fajr time nowadays. And started. She said, sorry. If he cannot take care of his creator, how is he going to take care of me? حسن البصري رحمه الله قال زوج ابنتك من تقي إن أحبها أكرمها إن أحبها أكرمها وإن كرهها لم يظلمها. Make sure you marry your daughter off to a God-conscious person. If he loves her, he'll ennoble her, he'll honor her. And if not, he's not going to wrong her. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala establish his love in our heart. So when it's time to meet him subhanahu wa ta'ala, we are ever ready. When he calls us subhanahu wa ta'ala, we ever ready to respond to his call. Because indeed, true success undoubtedly is in salah. When I counsel people, the first question I ask, how is your salah? Most of the time, hence Rasulullah said, أَوَّلُ مَا يُسْأَلُ عَنْهُ الْعَبْدُ. The first thing a servant is asked on the day of judgment is salah. If the salah is sound, it's reflected on everything else. أَقُولُ مَا تَسْمَعُونَ وَأَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ الْعَظِيمَ لِي وَلَكُمْ فَاسْتَغْفِرُهُ إِنَّهُ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. الحمد لله وكفى وصلاة وسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه. اللهم اهدنا فيمن هديت، وعافنا فيمن عافيت، وتولنا فيمن توليت، وبارك لنا فيما أعطيت. اللهم فرج كرب المسلمين في كل مكان. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. يا الله, grant us the best things for us in this life and the best things for us in the hereafter. Protect us from the punishment of the hereafter. Protect us from the punishment of the hell. And protect us from the hell of this life, which is being away from you, Ya Allah, Ya Arhamar Rahimin. Let us enter paradise in this life, the paradise of your closeness, Ya Arhamar Rahimin, and the paradise in the hereafter. Subhana Rabbika Rabbil Izzati Amma Yasifoon. Wa Salamun Ala Al Mursaleen. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Aqim As-Salaam.